Leave a like down below. Subscribe. Lightning Rod was the protector, constituent in the unusual Storm Titan game. In fact, some said he was the most popular participant in the event's entire history. No one had won as many medals as and no one else had anywhere near as many statues carved in his or her imagination. They were everywhere you look. Rod throwing a lightning bolt, Rod running a marathon, Rod lifting an entire herd of cyber cut elephants stacked on top of each other. There was even a statue of Ron Soaring, what feared off. Even when asleep, Ron was the most impressive specimen of miles around. No one performed like Ron. No one flexed their muscles like Ron. And no one polished off as many eggs of buckshot. And the crown popped right up and down in his feet. As everyone's favorite Storm Titan made his way into the air arena. "Hey, watch it," said Callie, as the exhibition table. "You're spilling that stuff everywhere." "Whoops, sorry," apologized Pop Frizz. Before taking a swig of the bottle, there was a puff of smoke and the scented whiff of brimstone. And Pop Frizz transformed into a hairy beast with more teeth than was healthy. "I'm just so pumped up to be here," he rumbled, suddenly taking up twice as much room as he had before his transformation. "Go, Lightning! Go, Lightning! Stop moving!" snapped Flat Pop. And the other side of Pop Frizz, "You are interfering with the unusual circuit." With a gulp, Pop Frizz shrank back with his normal size. "Whoop!" again. He fluttered, his eyes spinning from a sudden mirror cloud. "This is exciting, too, isn't it? I mean, look at this place." Papa had to admit that the arena was spectacular. Over a billion games had been played here, and everyone near the Storm Titans added more seats. The stands stretched for miles and seated millions of spectaculars. All the stood in the middle of the field, poking up the applause, thrusting his bubbling muscles. And flash of shining smile, Callie was running too. Brad was in his element here, surrounded by his adoring fans. Yes, Callie knew that Brad loved being a Skylander, protecting the magical realm of Skyland from the forces of darkness. But he knew also massively proud of his sporting accomplishments. They all were, "Do you think he's going to do it?" Popcorn asked, half raising a soda bottle to his lips before being stopped by Droppet. "Do you think he's going to break the record?" "There is a 99.999% probability that Rad will hunt it." That hunt it means like he's going to fail. Said Pop Fred, looking completely rewired. "Yep," he said, "yes," whispered Callie as a hush fell over the crowd in the royal box. The king of the storm titans raised his hand. "My friend," he boomed, with a voice of a thousand thunderstorms rolled into one, "please be silent for our guest of honor." Besides the king stood a tall, thin man, leaning heavily on a crystal top staff. It was a master eon, Skyland's greatest portal master. Master Eon had been asked to open this year's game, but he looked so old and tired. Callie frowned. She knew the last few weeks had been rough, tough for the ancient wizard, but she hoped that excitement of a game would retrieve him. So the portal master smiled as he drew himself up, his eyes resting on Lightning's rod far below. "People of Skyland," Master Eon said, his voice magically afloat around the stadium. "It's my pleasure to pronounce these games open." A buzz of excitement rumbled around the assembly throne. "And without further ado, we shall enjoy the first event, the 500-ton hammer throw, in our first convention, Lightning Rod." The crowd roared once again as Lightning Rod approached the massive bell, metal ball, and chained at the center of the field. It was twice the size of Titan, and yet he grabbed the heavy chain without hesitation, straining, and he began to spin the ball around faster and faster, rapidly crackling up and down the metal base. Callie couldn't help but be impressed. She often worked with Skylanders, training them to use their powers, but she'll never see Lightning Rod lift something that's heavy, let alone spin it round. "He's gonna win," Pop Fred was out babbling, almost beside himself. "Gonna get the gold. I just know it." But Droppet didn't say anything. Callie turned and saw that he wasn't looking at Lightning Rod, but into the sky. "What's wrong?" he asked. The fur of the back of his neck bristled. "That is wrong," Droppet replied, pointing towards the cloud with her claw. Callie turned to see Sterling's balloon drifting high above them. If Lightning didn't need him to complete the sentence or to bow. She knew who owned the balloon. It was Flynn, the so-called best pilot in the Skylanders, and someone who seemed to have a knack for flying into trouble. The guy had an ego the size of an entire island, but he helped the Skylanders time and time again. "We've got to warn them," Callie cried out. "Too late," reported Jethro as the storm tightened let go of the train and slid the hammer into the air. It rocketed up, soaring over the head of the crowd, straight for Flynn's balloon. Okay, so later on this day, we'll read chapter 2, Incoming. Okay, so we're going to close that book. Like and subscribe down below. Leave a comment down below. And you might be in this one giveaway of an iPod. See you guys next time on Entertainment for Kids!